How's it going? Welcome back to A-Level Lessons Online. Alright, this video we're going to be looking at macroecons again. Moving on to this concept, alright, this concept that you need to know, these terms that you need to know, right, it's going to be your GDP and your GNI, Gross Domestic Product, as well as your Gross National Income. Alright, so we're going to be looking at these two concepts and how they differ. Okay, which one do you need to use when it comes to the examinations? Alright, so just sit back, enjoy this video in your bed, in your house, wherever you are now, alright? And we'll go through this quite quickly. It's quite a small part of the entire syllabus. Alright, so gross domestic product. Okay, this is basically the book definition of what GDP is. It's good to know, alright? Because sometimes they manage to explain the concept of GDP. This is the definition that you want to give, alright? So GDP refers to the total monetary value of the final output. Okay, remember it's going to be the final national output produced within the geographical boundary of the country, regardless of the ownership or factors of production over 1 year before adjustment for depreciation or inflation. All right, so essentially what GDP means, okay, it's basically the total value of any output, okay, the total output within a country. So it's to be within the country itself. And this is regardless of who owns it. Okay, whether a foreign company owns it, whether a local-based company owns the output and the factors of production. Okay, it doesn't matter who owns the factors of production. Right? And this has to be done over 1 year, okay, before the adjustment for depreciation. Okay, so GDP, there are two types of GDP. There's going to be nominal as well as real GDP. Okay, so nominal GDP basically is known as kind of like the money GDP. It basically means that there is a nominal rise, and usually anytime you see something that mentions nominal, it basically only refers to a change in price, a change in quantity, or it could be a change in both as well. Okay, so as seen over here, when nominal income increases, it can be due to an increase in price, quantity, or both. Alright, so this is what we always look at when we look at nominal. So nominal GDP does not account for inflation as well. Okay, later on you see that real GDP is the opposite. Okay, nominal GDP does not account for inflation, which is the rise in general price levels that we've already gone through before. So usually, as far as possible, right, nominal GDP isn't really, say, used a lot. Okay, reason being is because it is hard to tell whether the economy has grown in terms of its GDP based on the output or whether it's grown based on the change in price. Right, so as far as possible, we always tend to use real GDP when it comes to drawing of your graphs, when it comes to explanation, okay, which, as seen on the right-hand side, okay, is used as economists are interested by in examining whether an economy is growing by producing more output over time. Right, so the reason why real GDP is good, okay, is because it's focused specifically on a change in output, a change in quantity. So a change in quantity would mean that there has been an increase in productive capacity, which shows that the economy is actually growing in the long run. So that's why we want to use real GDP instead. So when your real national income increases, okay, it is only due to a change in quantity like I've just mentioned. Okay, and real GDP is also adjusted for the effects of inflation. So any rise or fall in general price level, real GDP will take that into account as well, and it will adjust accordingly. Hence, it actually is a better reflection of economic growth, right? Because it already takes into account whether inflation has occurred or not. So it's kind of like a factor that it has taken out. So it's very, very clearly focused on only showing a change in the level of your national output. Alright, so then moving on to gross national income. Okay, gross national income is similar to GDP, but it kind of like has a slight tweak, okay, in terms of your factor income, okay, your factors of production. So GNI, okay, basically refers to GDP plus the factor incomes earned by residents overseas. So residents, right, so it's locals that are working overseas minus the factor incomes earned by non-residents in the domestic economy. Alright, so factor income includes ages, interest profits and rent earned. Okay, basically what GNI means, okay, is it's looking straight up at your locals. Okay, we're looking at nationals, we're not looking at any foreigners that are working in the country itself. Alright, so GNI is a good measure for your overall national income of a country. Okay, reason being is because you are taking into account the income that is earned by all of your own people who are working overseas, but at the same time you're looking at your own country, and in order to to see how much the locals in total are making, you minus out all of the incomes that are earned by foreigners in the country that you are measuring this in. Alright, so it only takes into account locals from overseas and locals in the country itself. Okay, that is what GNI is. Alright, so GNI is going to be a better reflection of standard of living, which we will go through very soon. Okay, and it basically it shows whether the living standards of your own people, okay, the locals in the country, are good or whether it's not desirable at the moment. So that is basically the main difference between GDP and GNI. So then now we look at what are the difficulties, okay, when it comes to measuring national income to begin with. So there are just several difficulties. Okay, these may just be required of you in the form of evaluation during your case studies or during your essays. So essentially the first difficulty is that there's going to be difficulties in obtaining reliable information. Okay, reason being is because of this idea of imperfect information that exists in the real world. So incomplete information may actually be derived, okay, especially in LDC, the less developed countries, due to a lack of technology. So you are unable to measure certain levels of changes in output. You can't really measure the factor income of people overseas. So these are things that could limit, okay, the measuring of your national income, be it GNI or GDP. One more thing is because of non-marketed items. Okay, this is basically referring to your underground economy. Not underground economy. This is referring, because underground economy means that it's slightly illegal, sort of. Non-marketed items are basically any sort of goods or services that are being unpaid, okay, or that they are self-consumed. Okay, so these can also refer to voluntary services. So all of these may have a bit of transaction taking place, but none of these are actually measured officially. Right? So as a result, they are non-marketed. Okay, they aren't actually on the market. Alright? Okay, so then last one is the underground economy. Okay, underground economy has two versions. Okay, some people call it a black market, some people call it the underground economy. I see it more as the underground economy being an overarching like umbrella, and the black market is just one of the subsets below it. Okay, because not everything in the underground economy is illegal. Alright, for example, tuition is under the underground economy. Okay, essentially what underground economy means is basically that it refers to any service or goods that are basically exempted from taxes. Alright, so anything that's exempted from taxes is going to be underground economy. Anything that is within the black market tends to be things like drugs, all of your, I don't know, all your e-cigarettes, smoking stuff, right? Those are basically part of the underground economy because they are also illegal for that specific country as well. Alright, so I've already gone through this GNI. Okay, so an overall comparison of the two, okay, GDP and GNI, just take note for this entire topic. Okay, I don't have exam requirements for this topic, okay, because usually it's not really something that will come out. Okay, it's more of a general knowledge that you need to know. So GDP takes into account factor ownership regardless, while real GNI just focuses on the total market value of goods and services produced by local resources. So if you need to remember anything, the only difference would be your locals. Okay, one of them takes into account locals, the other one of them only focuses on locals, the other one focuses on everything in general. So usually we'll try and use GNI for measuring standard of living, which I'll be covering in the next video. So reason being, okay, I think you have been able to see it by now, is that GNI tends to be the better measure when it comes to a lot of these things, okay? But overall, when you're measuring the entire country's output, we still want to use GDP, okay? The reason why we still use GDP is because you do want to take into account the total national output produced by the country, and this is regardless of the factors of production, which means that whether it's foreigners or not, they are still part of the national output that is being produced within that country. Right, GNI is more for specific measuring of only locals, okay, when you want to actually assess the living standards of your locals and see if it can be improved, then we'll use GNI as a measure to only specifically target locals. Alright, so that's the difference, okay, and that's actually all I have for this video. Quite a short one, I would say. So go and learn what GDP and GNI is, understand the differences, and when it comes to the examination, if you see the two concepts in the exam, you'll be able to tell what's the difference lah, and answer accordingly. Alright, so if not, that's actually all I have for this video. If you did enjoy it, be sure to give it a like, as well as to subscribe to the channel. It doesn't cost you anything, so it really does help me out if you could just kindly do that as well. If not, if you have any questions, yeah, you can leave it in the comment section below and I will answer them as well. And the next video should be on living standards, and we'll have a few more in between on geog, math, a bunch of mismatch of different content stuff that'll be coming out in a few weeks to come. So do stay tuned, and if not, I'll see you guys in the next one. Have a good one. Bye bye.